हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 9 ज्योग्राफी। लेट अस कंटिन्यू द सेकंड चैप्टर एंडोजेनेटिक मूवमेंट। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन हाउ अर्थक्वेक टेक्स प्लेस एंड इट इज डिवास्टिंग द रीजन। मेनी लाइफ एंड प्रॉपर्टी कम्स इन एंडेंजर। So, in this way, we have seen also this movement takes place in the interior of the earth, especially in the mantle. Tremendous energy is released from there, and this energy causes earthquake and volcanoes. These movements are classified on the basis of velocity, direction, and landforms they produce. Till here we have seen. Now let us study the slow movements. The effect of slow movements can be seen in the form of formation of mountain and continent on the earth's crust. This can be explained as below. So, the direction of the wave movement. Waves are moving towards each other. They are coming towards each other, and therefore faults are taking place. Because of that, folding, the mountains are folded. When the waves move away from each other, again the faults are created, and then fault planes are created. So they go away from each other. So we will see in this in more detail. So we are told to do activity. Activity 1. Take a 30 centimeter long paper strip. Place your hands on both the end of the strip. Move both the hands towards each other, giving pressure on the strip. Observe what happens to the strip. In activity 1, the strip was moved by placing hands on both ends. The work performed on the strip at that time is called compression. So, compression means pressure was given on the center of the strip from both the ends. As a result, the strip moved and folds are formed. Similarly, due to pressure on the earth's crust, movements are generated and folds are formed. So let us see fold mountains. Energy is transformed. Energy is transferred from the interior of the earth. Because of these energy waves and pressure working towards each other and in a horizontal direction, the layers of the soft rock forms fold. If the pressure is very high, large-scale folds are formed and their complexity increases. As a result, the surface of the earth gets uplifted and fold mountains are formed. So, through this experiment or the activity, when we put pressure on the strip from both the sides, the strip, see what happens to the strip. But here we are told that fold mountains are formed. So when you do this activity, you will realize how fold mountains are formed. So I want you to do that. For example, the Himalayas, the Aravallis, the Rockies, the Andes, the Alps are major fold mountains of the world. So these are all fold mountains because of the compression these mountains are formed. Now we move towards the second activity. Take a long strip of thin paper. Hold one hand of the paper in your right hand. Hold the other in your left hand. Pull both the ends away from each other. Observe what happens to the strip. In activity 2, tension is created when you pull both the ends away from each other. Similarly, when movements occur in the opposite direction to each other, tension generated and faults are formed in the Earth's crust. So, we have seen earlier when the compression takes place, faults are formed, and here again the faults are formed. Because of compression, the mountains are formed. And because of tension, the Rift Valley or the Black Mountains are formed. Therefore, tension is created. Then, formation of Black Mountains takes place and formation of Rift Valley also takes place. How? We are going to see one by one. So, Black Mountains, because of internal movement, horizontal waves moving away from each other are formed. This causes tension on the layer of the rock. This leads to formation of fracturing in the rock. These are known as faults. So, faults are fractured. Cracks develop in them. Similarly, waves coming towards each other in hard rocks also form faults due to compression. So, faults are formed when a part of the Earth's crust in between two parallel faults is lifted, it looks like a block. So, you can see in the picture there how the middle part is uplifted over there, lifted up. And therefore, it looks like a block. So, hence, this mountain is called Black Mountain. Such a landform is known as Black Mountain. The hilltops of Black Mountains are flat. In the early stage, they do not have any peaks. So, I can give you the example of Meghalaya Plateau. Even in our area, we have Mahabaleshwar. The tableland is also an example of Black Mountain. So, these Black Mountain, their slopes are steep. For example, Black Forest Mountain in Europe, Meghalaya Plateau in India, and I have given you the example of Maharashtra also, that is Mahabaleshwar. Panchgani has a tableland, which is also the part of the Black Mountain. And this, if you go on top, the side edges, they are very steep. You can see the valley deep inside. But on top, a flat land. So, that is considered as Black Mountain. And in the world, Black Forest Mountain and Meghalaya Plateau are the example of these. Now, dear student, in the next lecture, we are going to study Rift Valley, how the formation of Rift Valley, how it takes place. So, till then, goodbye and all the best.